The Department of Natural Resources keeps a close eye on the air quality in southern Wisconsin all through the year. Meteorologist Sally Severson shows us how the air is monitored and how it can affect you.
There are over 1,000 air quality monitoring sites around the U.S., including the 16 locations in our area. The equipment measures ozone, particulate matter, and other pollutants. Concentrations of these pollutants are then translated into the air quality index, which is easy to understand. Each air quality category has a color assigned. Green means good air quality, and red means unhealthy air is in place. When the air mask gets dirty, watches or advisories may be issued.
We have two different kinds of advisories that we send out. One is called an air quality watch, and that's when the forecasters predict that the next day's air quality will be poor. The advisory, then, is issued when those limits are hit.
Ozone is the most common pollutant for us. Gas engines, emissions from smokestacks, and outdoor burning all contribute to particle pollution and ozone. And while ozone is beneficial up high in the sky where it filters the sun's damaging rays, it can be harmful when it's formed at the surface of the earth. Ozone is created during the day when nitrogen oxides and volatile organic compounds cook in the warmth and sun. Weather plays a role too. Early morning southwest winds blow the pollutants back out over the lake. And then when the lake breeze develops during the afternoon, the pollutants are carried back toward land, resulting in higher ozone levels. When an air quality advisory is issued, it means ozone and or other pollutants have reached concentrations where it may make you feel sick. It's especially true for some at-risk people.
If you have a respiratory condition, you want to take it easy outside. But the effects could be anything from runny eyes, difficulty breathing. If you have asthma, it might be an irritant, so that could trigger an episode.
If you have heart or lung disease, or care for babies or senior citizens, you should try to limit your outdoor exposure on days when air quality advisories are issued. You can help lower pollution levels by doing a few simple things like combining trips to reduce driving, postpone using gas engines like lawnmowers, and wait to gas up the car until later in the day.
Anybody can do anything any time of the year, and it's all simple things. It's, again, sometimes things that are good for the environment are even good for the pocketbook. So reducing energy use, turning up that air conditioning in the summertime a little bit, converting the compact fluorescent lamps, just anything that would reduce energy consumption.
We're just coming into the warm air in summer. It's the most common time for Wisconsin to experience trouble with air quality. We'll tell you about air quality watches and advisories on WISN 12 News and WISN.com. Sally Severson, WISN 12 News.